Good morning, Ridge, and welcome back to another week of Tribe TV. I'm Isabella.
And I'm Adriana.
Today we'll be talking about the do's and don'ts at homecoming.
Why y'all shouldn't rely on Google Translate, a sports recap,
skating tips, and last but not least,
Coach's Corner. With homecoming right around this corner, here are some tips on how to have a successful night.
Hi, I'm Nia, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to be successful at homecoming. And no, this isn't a jab for all the boys who want to tell me how good they are at getting girls. This is just for the day of the event, okay? The first don't is don't brush your teeth. Trust me, girls hate minty breath. It reminds them of the dentist and gum and disgusting, like, you don't wanna have gum in while you're kissing a girl. Don't brush your teeth, okay? Number one thing you can do is eat a good, juicy hamburger with all the toppings on it and just leave the toothbrush at home, okay? The first do you wanna do is get super active and super sweaty before homecoming. I mean, armpit stains tell a girl that you're ready to go the extra mile, pun intended, to, you know, win them over and win their charms. Like, this is exactly what you want to do if you want to get your dream date. The biggest don't is don't dance. Yes, stop dancing. Number one do is like, that's what homecoming is for. You're coming home to your sleep. Also, when you wake up, you definitely want to play your own music. Like, who wants to listen to, you know, DaBaby or Lil Baby or whoever's on the radio? Like, we want to hear your music. You play what you have made. I mean, like, that's the best type of promotion ever.
I say right foot, yeah. Creep,
ooh. Last but definitely not least, take no pictures. I know everyone is on Instagram after and before homecoming with all their, you know, with all their friends and all their dresses and this and that. Do not do that, okay? Don't do it. Like, you want to be mysterious. Girls like mysterious guys. You do not want to be a guy that's all over social media, okay? So just play it safe, play it mysterious, and take no pictures.
Look at me. Look at you. Look at her. Look at you. Look at you. Look at me. No. Yeah, whatever, man.
I'm out at Brooklyn, now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the Narrow, but I'll be hood forever. I'm the new Sinatra, and since I made it here, I can make it anywhere. Yeah, they love me everywhere. I used to cop in Harlem, all of my Dominicanos right there up on Broadway. Pulled me back to that McDonald's, took it to my stash spot, 560 State Street. Catch me in the kitchen like a Simmons whipping pastry. Cruising down A Street, off-white Lexus, driving so slow, but...
We're just kidding. Don't do anything in that video. Here's another thing you shouldn't do. Rely on Google Translate.
Young lady, see?
Un beso.
Un beso, see?
Yeah, those tenny or ani.
What the?
Google Translate has been downloaded.
请问你知道历史课在哪吗?
Hold up. Say that again.
你知道历史课在哪里吗?
Do you have any romantic history with me? Go upstairs, bathroom emergency.
Oh, yeah.
Shoot!
Watch the sunset with me.
Hey, you know where Mr. Jones' room is?
Okay.
One second. Do you know where Mr. Jones' room is?
Sígueme en esta cuarto oscura.
¿Qué? No.
Wait.
Ay, Dios, ayúdame, por favor, para, oye, vale, vale.
Let's play a fun game and see who can find Gilly Man first.
Gilly Man!
Found him.
What's up, Bridge? Today we're going to be playing Find That Gilly Suit Man! The rules of this game are simple. You gotta find me, the guy in the ghillie suit. You got about 10 seconds to find me in each clip, so let's go!
Alright, this first one is a little difficult. You may be able to see me fast, but it may take a little bit. That first one, it was a little difficult. This one should be a little easier. Stick out a bit.
Gilly Man!
Those first two, they were pretty easy. This one's a little more challenging.
Gilly Man!
Alright, I'm blending in really well right here. I'd be really surprised if you could find me on this one.
Gilly Man!
Alright, those last few, they're a little easy. This one's gonna be more of a challenge.
Gilly Man!
Okay. This one should be pretty easy. It's a little scary back here. A big spider in front of me. Oh gosh. Okay, I'm getting out of here. It's way too big. Oh no. Okay. Y'all are never finding me. I'm way too hidden. It's really scary in these woods back here. Okay.
Gilly Man!
Now with our very own segment.
Your favorite segment.
Coach's Corner with Clenahan.
Me, just like 100 years ago. Does that make sense? I always know what he's thinking. I know what he's doing. I know when he's lying. I was a teenager once. Whoa, you know, I know it's not me. I'm not funny.
Okay. Don't grab the sex ed books. It's. Who? Somebody bring their pet?
Yeah.
I don't see it either, but I heard it. Page 24 and 25.
Yo, there's a dog here. What?
No, don't put that in. Don't make sure you don't put that because that. Hey, Pep Rally Thursday, everybody sign up to go to the Pep Rally. You need 100% attendance to show your school spirit. A trivia question. Come on through. What's your name? Julie? Julie, Coach Clenahan. Hey, are you going to the Pep Rally on Thursday?
No.
No? Do you know about the Pep Rally?
No.
Okay, you need to go to E-Class, and you need to click on, I will be attending the Pep Rally. That is for the homecoming festivities this week. Guys, a steakhouse, a local steakhouse, and the president of our university, he's eating a couple of tables over, okay, he's having the steak. It's a little dry, okay? It was the only thing we had in the little restaurant. The food was okay. Out of the corner of my eye, I see this guy flip over his entire table. Stands up, big guy, stands up, flips the table over. And then he goes from here, and he's hanging up, and you know, he was a bigger guy. It was hard to actually, you know, get your arms around him to give him the Heimlich maneuver. But his wife was crying. She's screaming. You know, she's screaming. She's got a napkin in front of him because I think she knows what's about to happen because he's about to spit some stuff up, right? Like, she's getting ready for it. You know, it all comes out. And she was ready. She knew it to anticipate, you know, because it all, a series of golf claps that went around the restaurant. Can y'all always remember that pressure is self-inflicted? Prepare. If you know you're ready for anything, whether it's a test, whether it's an extracurricular activity, no matter what situation you're in, where you feel like there may be pressure, just know that if you're always prepared, or if you know that you have worked as hard as you could towards what it is you want to do or achieve, you have to trust it. You have to trust your preparation. You have to trust what you're done. And if you ever feel pressure, it should just be lifted away.
Sports, here's John.
Good morning, Peachtree Ridge. I'm John Dutton, here to give you your weekly sports recap. Varsity softball lost to North Gwinnett yesterday, but looks to make a statement as they take on Norcross at home tomorrow. The Lady Lions are 2-1 in region play. Varsity volleyball lost to North Gwinnett 2-0, but won against Discovery 2-0 yesterday. The Lady Lions play Tequila and Collins Hill tomorrow at home, so show up and support. Last but not least, our homecoming football game is this Friday. Our varsity football team will take on Berkmar in their first game in region play. It's Toga Night, so come out and support. And our cross-country team is still running around somewhere.
That's all we have for you this week. I'm Isabella.
I'm Adriana. And thanks for watching. And make sure to follow us on all of our socials. And go Lions!